Hi, I'm Alton Brown, the host and culinary commentator for the Food Network series Iron Chef America. And ingredients are a big deal to me, especially today, what goes into noodles. Now, I was hoping that we could get into Mr. Ping's place to examine the noodle-making phenomenon, but ever since Kung Fu Panda came out, it's been a little tough to get a table in there. And that's why we're here in Beverly Hills at the next best thing, Mr. Chow. In the hands of the master, this can be magically converted into something you would actually want to eat. I do not have the magic in my hands, so I'm going to put the dough down, back away, and wait for a master.
Here comes Danny Yip, the executive pasta chef at Mr. Chow. Now just watch what he does with this, because this may be the best culinary magic trick you've ever seen. It's just a rope of dough, right? Being stretched and kind of tossed around. Nothing magical about that. We'll just wait a minute. That's just flour. It's not pixie dust or anything, nothing magical. A little bounce, a little twist. It's very rhythmic. It's very kind of hypnotic. You're getting very sleepy. Bounce, twist, bounce, bounce, twist, bounce. Same thing over and over again. But it's still just a rope of dough, right? It's nothing special. It's not like noodles or anything. Hey, it's long, but it's not noodles. Hey, picks it up again. Alright. Okay, so he's making noodles, right? So there's like what, 8? So that means that this time there should be 16. Or would it be 8 squared? 8 times? I don't know. A little stretch, a little fold. Now look at that. Now that looks like hundreds of noodles. Huh? How's it do that? A little flour. Yeah. Abracadabra. Nice trick. Okay, let's take a little closer look at what Mr. Yip is doing. Let's try to figure out what's really going on here. Okay, here comes Mr. Yip again, and he has a very, very elastic yet plastic dough. It's really just some flour, some water, and a little bit of salt. Now he's bouncing it against the board like that to create what's called gluten. You see, wheat flour has the ability to form this kind of protein mesh that is very, very stretchy and can allow for things, well, like that. Now every time he twists, he's actually creating a bunch of noodles. You see that twist, and then he bounces again, and then the twist. Every time he's doing that, more and more noodles being created. You just can't see them yet. Okay, now when he puts it down, watch, he's gonna, cutting off the end. That is going to allow for the unfurling of the noodles later on. And there, you see, closer shot, you can see that there are actually dozens, maybe even hundreds of noodles already in there. They've just been very tightly wound together. Now, the stretching, he doubles it over, he pulls. He rolls the end, he drags in the flour, he doubles it again. He bounces, he rolls the end, a little bit more flour. Each time, the number of already, I don't know, dozens of noodles being doubled over and over and over on themselves. So by the time he's done with this process, he's got, I don't know, hundreds maybe of noodles in there. Stretch, roll the end, drag in flour, and pull. You could only do this with wheat flour because it's got those proteins that are necessary. And there he's got his stick, and there, noodles. Very, very long noodles. Of course, those are too long, even for a skilled noodle slurper to slurp. So he's going to cut those down into a reasonable size. Yeah, that's a little bit more like it. And into boiling water or just simmering broth, depending on how he wants to present them. That, my friends, is the work of a master. Don't try this at home.
It's like a magic trick. Only one you can eat. Now, a few pointers on eating your noodles. Keep in mind that they are a symbol of longevity, so you don't want to cut them up with a knife, okay? That would be bad luck. Another thing, I don't care what your mom taught you, it's okay to pick up the plate or the bowl while you eat. And as for slurping, well, it would just be plain rude not to. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'd like to have my lunch.
That's it. I'll have my lunch, okay?